messages to weaken their morals. Now 11 months of this torture, so this is really unbearable. They are under permanent threat by the Iraqi forces. They are denied their legal status. The families, lawyers and also parliamentarians are banned to visit the camp. Also NGOs and human rights activists that want to visit the camp, they are banned to visit the camp by the Iraqi forces. As you know, Ashraf residents, they had some gainful activities with which they could earn their lives. This is also suppressed now, so they cannot work and earn money as they used to do in the past. And they have also severe limitations for their freedom of movement inside the camp, which is something that for them, as you can understand, is something that is causing a lot of trouble. I regret to say it, perhaps it sounds very hard, but I must say it, both the Iranian regime, and I say it with regret, a part of the Iraqi government, they have both, the Iranian regime and a part of the Iraqi government, have turned virtually Ashraf into a prison. Because when you are in a place where you cannot have visits from your family or from a lawyer or from any visitor that want to see you, this is really a prison. You are in a prison. During the past 2 years, several parliamentary delegations from Europe and a large number of other parliaments have urged the government of Iraq to be allowed to go to Camp Ashraf.